Mohammed prays before breaking his Ramadan fast with his family. This year, they're observing Ramadan as refugees, along with hundreds of thousands of other Rohingya crammed into this camp in Cox's Bazar.
Last year, in Ramadan, it wasn't so difficult in our home village in Myanmar. At least we could get all the basic essentials like fish, meat, and vegetables. But over here, we just can't afford them. Now we only have rice, lentils, and cooking oil that we get from the aid agencies. It's really difficult here.
It's the monsoon season. Heavy rains and winds lash down on the flimsy tents, turning the ground into deep mud. That's why aid agencies are trying to build new, sturdier housing. This is a safer location, away from the hills, which are vulnerable to landslides. And some of the refugees are being hired to help build their new homes.
Our community is facing a lot of challenges. Many of us are living on dangerous hills and rough terrain, and the bad weather conditions put our lives at risk. Now, we're making new homes in a safer zone to accommodate some of the Rohingya families.
The expansion of the camps also means that no one is expecting the Rohingya to be returning home to Myanmar anytime soon. There are almost a million of them here in Bangladesh. Many say in this holiest month of Ramadan, they are thankful they are safe, but their lives remain a daily struggle. Stefanie Dekker, Al Jazeera.